Yes, you're watching again the blueprint, and we're watching for the reason of knowing Jesus demonstrates how to walk this walk as children of God. And we come to a bit of a strange healing.
Yes.
In this little story in chapter 8, we see a guy being healed.
Yeah.
And then Jesus prays again for a complete healing. Yeah. What's happening over there?
Yeah, that's you're saying a very interesting story, but it is. I mean, I remember when I first read it, I had to read it again, almost like again and again, and go like, am I reading right here? Is this what's actually happening? Goff, I want to say I've learned a lot out of this piece. For me, this has meant a lot to me for praying for the sick and for persevering and pushing through. But just to sketch you the picture, what's happening. Here's this blind man, and he begged Jesus to touch him. He took the blind man by the hand and led him outside the village. When he had spat on the man's eyes. That's very interesting, eh?
So it's actually, rude.
It's a bit rude, yeah. He spat in his face, on his eyes. Well, it spat on his eyes. He spat. Jesus asked, do you see anything? And so the man replies, he looked up and he said, I see people and they look like trees. So he wasn't completely healed right.
But it's a miracle already.
But it was already a miracle because it was already further than what it was.
Yes.
And then Jesus put his hands on him again. I don't think he spat on him again. He just put his hands on him again.
Yeah.
And in the next moment, what do you see? And the guy can completely see.
Praise God.
And he's completely healed. That's amazing. And then it leaves us with that question. Why twice?
What's happening over here?
Yes.
Voldu has often, in the healing rooms training, he refers to this and he says, well, if Jesus once had to pray twice, what stops me?
Yes.
So have you ever been in a situation like that?
That's exactly what I've learned out of this when I first read it, is the fact that Jesus prayed twice for somebody, and often people come and they want prayer, and you pray and you don't see something happening the first time. Now you've got two choices what you're going to do here.
Yeah.
Oh, go, well, if anything changes, let me know.
Yeah.
Or be reminded of the scripture where the guy got healed when Jesus laid his hand on him the second time.
Yes.
And to go, but I can then do it again and I can pray again. But I think there's a bit of a wisdom when it comes to that. And that's what I've seen, especially if we've taken some people out to go pray for somebody or to just go share the gospel, is that as long as those people are fine with it, I think that's very important. Yeah. You don't just go up to someone and go, hey, can I pray for you? You pray for them. Okay, thank you. Has anything happened? No, nothing happened. Okay, I'm going to pray again.
Can I just stop you there for a moment? Because even just praying and, oh, is your knee sore? I pray for your knee.
Oh, yes, yeah.
And I didn't even ask.
Yes, is there anything?
Because that's a stretch of faith. I've just prayed. Am I expecting that something happened?
Yeah.
Or am I just sending you
just
away?
Just doing that religious prayer. I'm just doing what I need to do.
That in itself is a heck of a stretch. Yeah. I mean, the first time that I had to do that, I felt, do I really want to ask? What's the answer? No.
It's almost better to just go, oh, I've done my job. I've prayed. Well, have a nice day. Go home.
Step one is saying, yes, I'll pray for you. And then walk away.
Yeah.
Step two is having the boldness to say, let me pray now.
Yeah.
Step three is to say,
has anything changed?
Yes.
Is there any difference?
And then we come to this. Yeah. If nothing changed or if something changed, what then?
What then? Do you pray again?
Yeah.
And yes, I do believe we pray again. Definitely. Yeah. And can I share a testimony on that?
Please do.
So there was a young guy who came to youth. He came on two, and I've shared this testimony before, but he came to youth on two crutches. And I think, I don't know what happened, was a bad accident on his knee, and it was really bad. He was on crutches and he literally couldn't put any weight on it. So we asked him if we could pray as a youth group together, and we ended up praying for him. No change, nothing. Yeah. But reminded of this scripture that we pray again. And every time we would ask, is there any change? No. Probably, but I don't know, maybe the fifth or the sixth time we started praying. Is there a change? Yeah, maybe a little bit better. But I just want to add this in. We didn't pray all this long prayers because it could be quite tiring if you like, go off and pray a whole essay there for the guy's leg. Just, Jesus, would you heal him because you love him? Thank you, Lord. Jesus, would you heal him? Any change? No. Jesus, we pray that you would heal him. We get somebody else to pray. And then we just carried on like that. And eventually the guy says, well, there's definitely something happening. I can sense there's a change. It feels like there's a change.
Yes.
And then by the 12th time, we took a bold step and I said, all right, we're going to pray again. And then I want you to hand me your crutches and see if you can walk. And we prayed, and this guy gave me his crutches, and he started walking.
And he was willing, right?
Yes, he was willing.
It's just important to put in there. You're not forcing somebody in.
Yeah. Every time we ask them, that's very important. We ask, are you okay if we pray again? Are you okay? And it stretches our faith.
Yeah.
And it puts us in a place of taking a bold move. And then we trust that the Lord comes through, which he did in this situation, really did.
What was the end of it?
The end was that this guy actually ran. He actually ran in the parking lot outside here to my car and back. And then he stood up straight, no crutches, and he started jumping up and down. And the Lord healed him. Amazing.
Praise God.
But what happened in that moment was great for him because he got healed, he experienced the Lord's love. But for us as a youth, Garth, it was massive.
You saw it.
We saw it with our own eyes. And I often wonder, I mean, I actually get just goosebumps when I tell you this, but I often wonder, what if we stop by number one or two?
Yeah.
Like, what if we just bailed out and said, ah, you know what, cool, nothing happened.
Mm.
And that's the thing of how far do you then go? How far do you push this thing? How far do you stretch it? We had peace that day to carry on. He was happy for us to carry on. And we really pushed it because I also want to say this. We were really hungry to see the Lord move there. But we were also wanting God to heal him.
Yes.
Because he was struggling. He had to have people carry his bag for him at school. Because he couldn't put weight on his back because of his leg. Yeah. Before
Praise
the Lord
God,
healed him.
Praise awesome. God.
Yeah.
Yeah. Back to our previous lesson though.
Mm.
It's not a proof of anything except that the Lord loves him. The Lord loved the people that prayed. And he loved you loving him.
Yes. Yeah. Definitely.
At the end of the day. So I think that's just follow the law of love.
That's it.
And
can I just say this? There has been times where I've prayed a couple of times for people and I haven't seen anything in that moment.
Yeah.
Does it mean that God didn't heal them? No, I don't know that. I don't know what happened later or anything. But what I do know is in that moment, I have seen stuff like that not happen. And then all it does is it just challenges me personally to get rid of myself again and my own pride and my nothing worried. To focus on the Lord and know that whatever we do out of love. Exactly like you're saying. Jesus loved, we love, and he tells us to do this and do it.
Now I pray, Lord, that you will give us both the boldness to ask again, and also the wisdom, Lord, in every situation to know how to do it, so that we will demonstrate your love and respect for people while we're pushing in for them to see your love. Thank you for that, Jesus. Amen.